many Palestinians, this is real life in the West Bank. Protests, tear gas. Part of their constant struggle for an independent country. But amid this chaos, Palestinian athletes like Woroud Sawalha are being given the chance to run under the Palestinian flag. It is, quite literally, an Olympic dream come true.
Miracles do happen, and with God's help, I will hopefully get a good result. Since they selected me for the Olympics, my running time has gone from 4 minutes to just under three. So I've seen a big improvement.
At her family's house in a small West Bank village near Nablus, Woroud showed me her collection of Palestinian sports awards. There have been many, particularly for her event, the 800 metres. But competing in the international arena is something of which she has no experience and was not expecting.
Honestly, I did not expect this because I did not think a woman would be selected to represent Palestine at the Olympics. My dream is to change the taboo of sports and women in Palestine.
In total, just four Palestinians, including Woroud, will be heading to London to compete in the 2012 Games. But the truth is, their chances of winning any kind of medal are pretty slim. For them, it's more about the thrill of competing than winning gold.
In Gaza, another Palestinian territory, another runner trains for his Olympic debut. Baha al-Farah wants to be a serious contender, despite a lack of proper sporting equipment and facilities.
I need a proper track to train on. At the moment, I just run on the roads or on the sand. Also, proper starting blocks are unavailable in Gaza. But hopefully, the lack of training tools won't affect me, and I can prove to the world that we can compete even without them.
But a place on the podium may be unrealistic, even an impossible dream. In other words, exactly what these Olympics are meant to be about.